He plays the violin. He tucks it right under his chin. And he bows, oh, he bows.
Hello, it's me, Seth Rudetsky. Couple things. First of all, this is not a backdrop. It's literally real. But it looks like a terribly painted set from the Brady Bunch Variety Hour. But it is real. It's A. B, I'm doing all my deconstructions in the same shirt because for Playbill, I'm constantly having to change my shirt. Don't have the energy to run to the wardrobe. So you'll be seeing a lot of bravat. By the way, the back of it, still got it. Anywho. Okay, today we're going to start with the 4th of July special. Wanted to do this 2 months ago. Didn't have the time. Labor Day special. Columbus Day? I don't know when it's going to come back. Anywho, 1776. That's right. The Mazzi musical. There's nothing to fold out. If you try to fold it out, you'll rip it. I'm obsessed with the show, and I've heard a lot of dishing of the show. So I wrote about this in my book, Cute Guide to Broadway, and people are like, that show sounds boring. It is amazing. So I'm beginning my deconstructions with my favorite Beltress, Betty Buckley, or for those of us from Texas, Betty Lynn Buckley. There are Jews in Texas. Anywho. Okay, so this is the first song she sings in the song. By first, I mean only. He plays the violin. She's singing about her husband, Thomas Jefferson. There's so many things to listen to. First of all, she was literally 22 when she got this gig. Her first day in New York. Hi, New York. Broadway star. So she got this amazing part, and she really changed the face of Broadway belting. People did not belt as high as Betty Buckley until Betty Buckley came along. The high note in the old day was like a B flat. Oh my God, strain my voice. Full D in this, you'll hear in a second. Okay, let us start from the beginning. I have my trusty iPod here, which I think is not turned off because I've literally babbled for so long. Okay, don't know how to turn it on. I literally know how to use a Walkman. All right, here we go. This is the very beginning. Betty Buckley, so many things to talk about, but let's listen for a second. Here we go.
Oh, he never speaks his passions. He never speaks his views. Whereas
now, right here. When she auditioned for the show, she's from Texas, she went, whereas other men speak volumes? And they're like, okay, cut, I'm a cowgirl accent. So she had to learn how to say volumes. Got that story straight out of a horse's mouth. Here, listen to it one more time for the volumes. Here we go.
He never speaks his views. Whereas other men speak volumes,
bye-bye.
The man I love is mute.
I love the vibrato right here.
In truth, I can't recall being wooed with words at all.
And then right here, she's like, I don't belt high. I've literally got a mix of G. I don't have a big voice at all. Totally tricking you. Listen.
Even now.
Deceptive. Okay, next section, please. Now, let me deconstruct this for a second. I'm going to go to the piano. The song is about how Thomas Jefferson plays the violin to woo her. And the actual melody of the song is based on the violin, which if you know to tune a violin, it's in fifths. So like when you tune a violin, it's... So that's why instead of like, he plays the violin. No, he plays the to a fifth based on the fifth of the violin. Very smart, Sherman Edwards. Thumbs up. Let's listen. And by listen, next track.
He plays the violin. He tucks it right under his chin.
By the way, another inside story. You know, she goes, and he bows, oh, he bows. Well, at her audition, she had to sight read the song. So she was just like, and he bows. Yes, he bows. Okay, he's not really bowing to you. He's bowing. Inside scoop. Here we go.
And he bows, oh, he bows. For he knows, yes, he
beautiful
knows.
Melody.
That it's high.
Okay, I want you to hear that. Because it's written, hi, 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 diddle, diddle, twixt my heart. It's written very like, I'm a robot, twixt my heart. But she does amazing back phrasing, so I want you to hear that. Hold on, hold on, listen to the back phrasing. Back phrasing.
For he knows, yes, he knows,
back phrasing.
That it's high, 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 diddle, diddle, twixt my heart, time and his fiddle, my strings run strong. High, high,
now I want to talk about this for a second. Listen, I love the beautiful minorness that comes in because it goes to the piano, please. It goes, hi, 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 hi. Da 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 da. That's where it gets beautiful. Listen to that, please. I'm obsessed with that phraseology. Okay, let me go back. Here we go. Okay, we have got to discuss the amazing violinist. First of all, the violinist is brilliant. That's soloing in the pit. Do not know his or her name. I'm not sexist. I have no idea. Okay, now the next phrase. What I love is the violin orchestration. She talks about how And I sigh, oh, I sigh, and the violin orchestration has gink. It's literally like the sound of someone sighing. Listen how creative this is. Okay, here we go.
I hear this violin, and I get that feeling within.
Right here.
And I sigh, oh, I sigh. He draws me.
Then I'm obsessed, the crazy frantic triplets that come in. It goes, this crazy, by the way, I'm a violinist, can only play in first position and open strings. The thought of playing these triplets, I never in a million years. Listen how amazing the triplets are. I'm obsessed. Okay, hold on.
He draws near, very near, and it's high, high, high.
That crazy?
And goodbye to the fiddle. My strings run strong. High, 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 high.
Mine is coming in here, right? Now, you can't fully really hear it on this. Maybe if we edit this well. But before the violinist plays his next solo, he takes a crazy breath. He's like, bum, bum. Okay, I'm obsessed. If you listen to it with headphones, you can hear it. It's a crazy deep sniff. Totally obsessed. Here we go.
Undone.
You have to listen. It's totally Brent Vaccaro. Now, this solo is beautiful. I'm obsessed with the beautiful violin solo. Then all the violins come in. And then finally when it goes, bum, bum, ba-dum, bum, I'm like, it's going to be the most beautiful violin solo ever. No, it literally goes to the French horns. Still, Deb, I love the violin so much. I don't want the straight tone French horn ruining my phrase. Listen to this. Amazing solo. And some more violins coming in a second. More strings. Big scale. Now, it's gonna be strings. It's gonna be strings. Now here, I love this. I love the modulation. I love how it's first it's a trio. Hi, 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 hi. And then Betty's like, and cut, I'm modulating. Hi, takes it up a half step. It is so exciting. Listen to this, here we go. Trio. Okay. How exciting is that? Barry Manilow, 10 years before Barry Manilow. Then her amazing high note, When Heaven Calls to Me, a D. Change the face, a Broadway belting. Nobody belted like that before.
Calls to me, sing me no sad elegy. Say I died, loving bride.
Listen how joyful it's going.
Loving wife, loving life, for it was high, high, high.
By the way, she's about to go, literally high note on an eval. High note on an eval, not an ah, which is nice and open, no, literally a tight E, Betty's specialty. Not an ever twill bay, not opening up the vowel, pure eval, brilliant singing. Here she goes. So joyful here, right? That phrase. And the little last minutia is I love, she goes, He plays the vi, instead of he plays the vi, she goes, he plays the vi. I love that backphrasing, not really backphrasing, changing of the rhythm. Here we go. One more time, I'm obsessed, hold on. I want to lip sync. Brava, La Buckley. And I'm out. Still got it.